Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Paul Plusa. Hello guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 15:52 hours on Monday, April 25th, 2016. I'm here with my very good friend Minkus.
Hello.
And I have never seen this before. This is so cool. Check this out. And I know 300 people are going to mock me because this probably exists all over the fucking world, but I've never seen it before, so it's new to me. Okay, so you got a motor. It's a starter motor on this engine. Engine runs on gasoline. Motor runs on electricity. So, starter motor, and Mr. Minkus just took the end case off, and God, that's dark as hell. But, okay, so here's your brushes. There's four of them. Okay, that's kind of cool. But this is the one I'd never seen before. Look at the end of the motor. The commutators are on the end of the motor. Not the side of the armature, they're on the end of the armature. And I have never seen that before, and that's just... Focus, you fuck! I've never seen that before, and that's just... That's just cool as hell. That is so neat. And there's four of them, which is for extra awesomeness.
The brushes don't look too bad.
Have you ever seen that before?
Starter motors, yeah.
Starter motor with the commutators on the end. Like... Because you have the commutator.
Right.
It's on the end, but it's on the side.
In the scheme of looking at most typical starters, no, you don't usually see that.
Okay.
But in looking at boat stuff, I've seen it before, yes.
Okay. Maybe it's a boat thing. I don't know. But, I mean, I've seen it radially, you know, like this. This is how you always see it. I've never seen them on the end. That is so cool. That is just fascinates me. Huh. The brushes aren't too bad.
Right.
I'd blow the shit out of it.
I'm going to.
But they're alright. I mean, you figure it's 80s vintage. There's that much left. It's good at least until the year 3000.
I'm going to lube that up too.
Oh! Before I forget about it. Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Paul Plusa. It's his first time. He just made the list. There are other people, one of whom is the great and powerful Alex Vaughn, who just came up to $25 a month. I think somewhere in there, you have to pick, I want a specific reward, and you have to pick if you're at the $25 a month, you have to pick that you actually want the title card thing. Do this because it makes me feel happy to be able to thank you every month. I think that's cool. And if you don't do that, you don't end up on a special list on my side. I've got a patron manager, and I've got a list of all the people who are... It's right at the top of these are the people whose names I read off every month, and I cycle through it now. So you're like, you're getting double because cool. I also want to thank John McFerrin, who went from $1 up to $5 a month. So thank you, sir. And what? It's a magnet.
I know. Look at the magnet.
Magnet's got a big chunk out of it right there.
Uh-huh.
A big, big chunk. Okay, so the start... Okay, the problem isn't that the magnet has a big chunk out of it. The problem I have, the real question I have to ask is, where is that chunk?
I can tell you where it's at.
Is the chunk pulverized and
That's...
all the little dust? Or is there, like, a big chunk of...
No, there's no big chunk in there. It's been ground and...
Okay, well, what did it do before it left? Is that chunk all this stuff?
No, that's,
Don't pull it out, but...
I'm not.
Smack it a little bit.
I was...
All right.
I'll get it cleaned up, don't worry.
Minkus,
look at it.
Make a piece of metal clean?
No, never.
That is so cool! Well... Missing that piece shouldn't affect it too much, because it's way off on an end, and it'll make the starter a little tiny bit weaker, but not by an appreciable amount. That's neat. You know what you're looking at?
Motor.
Well, in pieces. Do you know any of the parts? Okay, watch. This is the brush assembly. The electricity comes in on these, okay?
Okay.
These are the brushes. They're made of pressed carbon, graphite, and it's very slippery. Okay?
Okay.
These take the electricity and they touch here. And at the end of each of these, you can see there's a little loop of wire.
Right.
Okay. That little loop of wire goes up and around and then back down. Like, you can see the ends of the windings. So it gives you an idea. Don't move. Okay. So you can see, like, this wire from this... this is called a commutator here.
Okay.
And this is... this little thing is electrically isolated from the one on either side. Okay? So when the brush touches this... electricity goes through this wire, and it goes up, and it goes around. You can see it goes around on the top. Okay, you can see all the tops of all the windings. Okay, and each one of these is a separate winding. Mm-hmm. And like so that, if you look at a single strand, that's a wire, right? But that wire goes up and back and up and back and up and back. And that collection of wires is called a winding. Okay, and it's a coil of wire,
mm-hmm.
and it's arranged so that they're in pairs. So plus and minus for electricity makes this winding and or this winding, like there may be multiple windings hooked to a single pair of commutators. And this is weird because it's four, so stuff will happen at 90 degrees or something like that. And if you look, this electrical connection here goes to these two commutators.
Okay.
And the little spring under them is the commutator spring. And these two here go to the other side.
Just I think. Just
wait a minute.
Suspended.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. No, no, no. This here connects to these. These two connect to ground. So they're okay. 90 degrees off. Okay. So these two connect to the positive here. And these two connect to ground. So these two... we'll get electricity, and then the other side of these coils is these two here, so that's how it works. And that's why the coil goes around 90 degrees. Okay, so electricity in, electricity out. Electricity in, electricity out, like that.
Okay, that makes sense.
And then the number of coils in there, the number of sets of windings, is poles. So you'll have, you can have a single pole motor, you can have, which is called a monopole motor, which I can teach you how to make with a battery and a magnet and a paperclip, and it's really cool. And you can have like a two pole motor. You can have, you'll see frequently in stepper motors, you'll have two pole, four pole, stuff like that. And five pole is really common. In CNC equipment, you'll see five pole, sometimes even seven pole. I do a lot of modeling stuff where you'll see like five, seven, and more pole motors. The more poles you have, the smoother the motor runs, especially when you get into stepper motors and stuff like that. But that's, this whole assembly is called the armature. Okay, everything mounted to that shaft is the armature. This here is the armature. So this is your armature windings and all that. The other, where'd you put the, this, because you have magnetic fields, right?
We need a magnet on the
other
side.
Okay, yes, you need a magnet on the other side of the deal, there, and a chalk. Now, if you look at this, those are two big permanent magnets. This is a permanent magnet DC motor.
Okay.
In this motor, these are called the field, okay, because this makes the magnetic field that operates inside of.
Okay.
In a lot of motors, you'll see this done with more electromagnets, and they'll make what's called the field winding, which are usually just two big magnetic coils, and that creates your stator field. This is the stator here. That's the armature, or the rotor. Usually it's called an armature, but this is the stator. This part doesn't move.
Right.
So it's just two big magnets. Well, 1 7/8 big magnets. And a little chunk missing there. Probably from Minkus beating on it.
Mm-hmm.
He breaks stuff. Causes problems. You'll need that back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I miss any parts?
No.
Okay.
Stator, field windings. As far as the Mark motor itself.
As far as that motor goes, it gets way more complicated. You ought to see how stepper motors work. That shit gets weird.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you want to see the one that just fries your brain, shaded pole motors.
Look that up on Wikipedia. Sounds
shaded fancy. Pole motors. Really not fancy. The cheapest, shittiest, crappiest motors you'll ever see, shaded pole motors.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So what you got?
Oh, I'm just going to get to work on this.
Okay. I should let you get to work on that.
Get it cleaned up. Get the nut tightened down to where it's supposed to be.
Okay.
Get it finished cleaning up, put it back together, throw it in there.
And then it still won't start.
Prime the carbs.
We got to put the fuel tank back in it.
Not just yet.
Okay.
We're not going to bother doing that, because if it doesn't start right now, there's no sense in having the fuel tank in it.
Okay, so we're just going to...
I'm just going to fill the fuel bowls.
There's a fuel lead. There's a fuel rail. It goes over to the other side. There's a fuel filter.
And pump.
And pump.
Which has been rebuilt.
Okay.
The fuel line goes in right here. That's it. Right
this
there.
Is the fuel line in?
This is the fuel
line.
Okay,
so we could just hook anything on there and run it off a little can. All right, cool. All right. We'll be back.
More like a gorilla, though, because it's big and hairy.
You are voted most likely to be the staff gorilla.
That's about right. Now that Casey's gone.
From Minkus to Mungo. you're way more gorilla than Casey.
Oh, that's right. He's a Viking.
Yes. Okay, you got three. Hundred guys watching us are going to just so deeply understand your pain. Did you get it?
Yep.
You missed the half hour before I started rolling the camera.
There we go.
Look at that. Mad skills.
Nope, just mad.
All those years of college paid off.
Yeah, they did.
What's the hardest tear down rebuild of something you've ever done?
I haven't done a whole crud ton of stuff, so the hardest I'd have to say. Oh. I've done lots of lawnmowers.
Yeah.
Those are easy. Never really done a full teardown of everything.
Well, now you've done a complete starter teardown.
I don't remember this bolt being... Oh, that's right, because it sticks up and through. Duh. Moron. Yes, I talk to myself a lot.
Nobody else really listens to you.
I know, that's why I do it.
I've met your kid.
It's obvious he doesn't listen by the amount of road rash he has.
That's his new Devo cover band, Moped Road Rash.
I'm going to have to tell him that.
Yeah, but then you're going to have to spend 5 minutes explaining who Devo is.
He's heard Whippet, so he knows.
Okay.
If I just say, hey, bro, hey, you remember the band Devo? What?
David Bowie.
David Bowie, Jennifer Connelly. You remember the, I don't remember what they're called, but the guys that swap their heads and everything, do the weird dance.
Yeah.
Yeah. My nephew has a dog that looks like one of those. Yeah.
That's a mental picture that'll stay with me now. You got enough bolts there?
I'm not the one that designed it. I'd like to, just like whoever designed Buick Rainer, I'd like to destroy them because I had to replace an alternator in one of those.
Okay.
It's underneath the cowl by the dash, right?
Yeah.
And there's no room to get it between the pulleys of the engine and the strut tower.
Well, you know they put the alternator on before the engine goes in the car.
I know. You have to take the intake plenum off to get it out. And even then.
There was another vehicle I saw. Like, there's a Reddit I follow called Just Rolled Into the Shop.
Yeah.
Which you would love. And they had, I think it was a starter that a dude had to take the entire top half of the engine off to get to. I was like, wow! Well, that's a record.
Well, that's no different than the Corvettes and having to roll the engine to be able to get the back two plugs out.
Roll the engine? What do you mean?
They have it set up so that you actually take it and you undo the front top mount and the whole thing rolls so that you can get
Wow!
With my wife's car, the Ford Freestyle, I know it takes me 23 minutes to get it tore down to the point where I can replace the fuel injectors and spark plugs on the rear three cylinders.
So what's left after this?
This.
This is it?
Pretty much. Just got to put some, see about getting some premix in it and...
I got a gas can of premix made up.
I know we
do. You can use all you want. I'll make more.
I don't want a lot of it. I only need a little bit, just enough to see if I can get this thing to kick over.
Okay.
Serious? Is that harder to take? Always make sure your connections are tight. Not just the bolt.
The thing that weirds me out on marine engines is the complete and total lack of air cleaners. I understand why you don't really need them, but it's just weird.
Yeah.
It, 'cause the only other engines like this that I'm used to dealing with are lawnmowers where you really need an air cleaner.
Yeah.
But there's nothing to worry about sucking in. I mean, you might get a bug, but they'll just go out the other side.
Right.
That's not going to hurt nothing. Fuel line?
Yeah,
looks like fuel line.
That is the fuel line. It just didn't get connected back up to the pump, so I can use that to fill the fuel bowls, but I should probably just, I'll do that.
You can't fill the fuel bowls by, like, hooking it up to a gas can?
I can.
Because they got this thing. The little blood pressure cuff thing. Won't that fill the fuel bowls?
No, that primes it up to the pump. And then the pump would fill it up, but... But that's a lot more fuel to deal with. We can do it.
You can do whatever you want. So what's next?
Getting the fuel.
Yay! Let's go find the fuel.
Oh, so close.
Here, hang on a second. Oh no, I got it. I'm just gonna slack out of this.
Alright, now we need to slide this guy back up. Slip back in. Just like last time.
No, this is interesting.
This is actually how they built the pyramids.
Oh, totally.
I was there.
Yeah? Can I help you?
Jesse.
Oh, he's...
He knows I'm coming over.
Okay, go in, turn right.
Hey, Jesse, there's someone here for you.
Ready?
He's right around the corner there.
Out back? Correct, he's walking in right now.
You just gotta wait for it. There's a definite climax.
There's definite apex.
No, there's a specific climax to this, an exact moment.
I'm feeling some deja vu here. Very much so.
It's going much better today.
Yeah, because we effed it up.
Already figured
12 different ways the first time.
Scratching the paint.
I'll touch up the paint.
Scratching the paint. It's like a brand new engine hoist. See, this is where I start getting nervous. It's when that plate kicks back and takes out the pump section right off the ram there.
Hey, at least he's going kind of slow.
Right, look at that.
Take it up another 2 inches. I gotta try something here. Mr. Menkes, can you hold the camera a second?
Yes, I can.
Thank you.
With my dirty hands.
I need this as a ringtone. This is the bottom.
Okay. You're fine.
Okay, you wanna come over here. Because I want this sound nice and clean. You ready?
Yep.
It's gonna make an awesome ringtone.
You good?
You need to do it like they actually do with the gong. Hit it a few times and then hit it one good one so it get better resonance out of it.
Okay. Everybody quiet.
Thing. We're recording it with the camera. Now he's got to hit it again.
Now I got to do all that again, you asshole. You just got to not talk for a few seconds. Ready? Mark. City background noise.
Right.
I gotta take that into a studio at some point.
That's cool.
Do you guys have a loading dock where I could load in my KUKA 350 base plate?
Yeah.
What do you mean nobody's ever made that request before? What are you talking about?
I love how long it rings.
We used to have a band practice on Ionia Street called Rescue 666. That consisted of like three percussionists and a bass player. And one of the guys was named Viking Tom. His instrument was a marching bass drum laid horizontally on a very large, destroyed old chair. They only had one song that I ever learned. It may be the only song they had.
Put 4x4s back on 6x6.
It went on for about 15 minutes, and the only lyric and the title of the song is "Tastes Just Like Chicken," they say. They were cool guys.
No, I'm not talking. Do
you have any recordings of that?
We're good.
I don't know. We didn't have so much for blog back then. This is total OSHA. That's the safest thing I've ever seen.
Totally.
That's
just keep hands. Okay, bring it back up.
That's the greatest idea ever. So now we just reposition the bolts, pick it up, and set it on the table?
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, were you thinking about doing that with this?
Sure, why not?
I guess we can. Rig it for it. Grab the other set of bolts. They move a little bit when you swing a couple of pounds of steel.
Just a couple. Just a couple pounds.
Several? Oh.
The plate weighs... the other plate was, I think, 890 or something like that. This one I'd put, because it's significantly bigger, I'd put this one at probably around 1,100 pounds.
Sam estimated this as being 800 minus holes.
No, that was the other one.
Oh, okay.
Which is a size smaller.
I'm thinking we're going to do a cross, because why not? It'll be a little less sweet. So we'll do this guy here to there.
Oh, okay.
This is scary.
Crisscross applesauce.
Do not have bigger washers.
So you're going to pick that up with the engine hoist. You got a new problem.
Oh, the fact that we've got a bunch of sling above it?
Nope. The problem that you'll probably get the altitude, maybe, but you won't be able to get it on the cart because you can't get the cart in between the legs.
We'll come on from the corner again.
Yeah?
On the diagonal, over the wheels.
Okay,
the leg,
okay.
Cause
okay. I believe
I just,
you.
I wouldn't.
I'm not big on that.
And I don't have any of my shackles here.
Need more orange shackles.
Yeah, seriously, just a pair of those orange ones would be dope right now.
Don't you drive like a hardcore, awesome, badass, exploring Africa Jeep? I'm just saying, don't guys who drive these tend to have like rigging in the back.
If I had my tool bag with me, I'd have way more than enough. I got some 9.5 tons. I had a couple of 12 tons. And I've got the wee baby ones.
Those are the same size we got?
Yeah, those are, yeah. I think those are big.
No, those are the size smaller than that.
Oh no! They look closer.
Considering the fact that you can almost get that off. And remember, when tightening shackles, you tighten it down until it hits and then you back it off a quarter turn. That way you can always undo the pin. Because it screws in. Especially when off-road.
If your strap rolls across the pin, it can tighten it down with like a lot of force. That's a whole lot better.
Yep. Whoops.
Bucket fell.
Time to retire that one.
Yeah, you didn't hear the story about my kid. And his moped mishap. Flip it around. Yep. Turn it, spin it so it's all. You go. Get it spun in all the way. And back it off. Webbing always goes in like you. Now,
I'd stretch that thing out 2 more holes. Bruce, bring the snoot out at least 1 more hole, or he's not going to have enough altitude to do anything. Don't worry, before you pick that up, the cart will center itself under the load.
Even if that means kicking out the strap, or the clutch.
Yes.
Well, as you get it up there,
we gotta get one of those compressed air-powered pumps for that, yeah.
I'm sure they have an adapter.
If we use that, we've got
that riveter? Air over hydraulic riveter?
Yeah.
You just use that cylinder. It's the same thing.
Remember I told you it wouldn't fit in there?
Oh, wow.
Won't fit that way either.
Hmm.
You want me to do it?
With the tools at hand, or are we going to drop it and put it back?
All you need...
I can do it with the tools at hand. Come on, this is like one of those college engineering thought experiments. Can you solve this problem?
But you need is a
2x40. Let me solve this. I can do it.
Sure.
I can do it in 3 minutes.
What's your super fancy strategy?
You want to see?
Yeah.
Okay, hang on a second. Here, you take this. I'll be right back.
What are you doing? Those guys or me? Those guys are right. Fumble fucking up. Boys. I'm gonna go get a forklift.
He's getting the forklift. Despite the fact that he said he was gonna do it with the.
Just need to get
it. I know what you're talking about. And then once you get the two together, you can just hoist it up.
Because he's gonna grab the forklift.
The S10's all electric.
Okay, you can put those turnbuckles back on if you want. I'm doing a terrible job of filming right now.
Didn't we put the forklift on the charger yesterday for several hours?
Did you plug it back in?
No, because I'm a complete idiot. Nothing comes on if you don't plug it in. It came on. I just plugged it in and I still got no bars on the battery.
Figure close to 1,100
pounds. We got four of us. It's just grunted over there.
That's what I'm saying. Put that thing right here.
Get it as close as you can, and we'll just drunk the thing over. We've done stupider. So, where's the long 2x4s?
Over on the forklift. Front of the forklift.
Alright, now we actually do have an engineering puzzle to figure out, because the forklift battery's blocked.
How about good old American muscle?
Plate weighs 1,000 pounds. How much good old America muscle you got?
He's my neighbor. We can piece.
Is this fire truck?
No. I'm a pipe fitter.
Oh, well, really okay.
He's outbuilding Holland Power.
Okay, cool.
We can grab this thing out.
Oh,
I promise you.
Archimedes is back.
Hello, the lever. Archimedes is just the two.
Yeah.
Okay. You put your casters on it.
Well, I think they were saying this is at like its full height. And it's not full
that's as long as it gets.
So they need to be able. They still need to be able to straddle.
Red's right here. Yeah.
Wheels on 2x4s. We've never done anything like this, have we?
This is the best idea ever. Oh yeah. It's totally safe.
They make pretty durable days.
Yeah, I saw that, yeah. I told you, he built a street with a jet-powered street. Yeah, helmet doesn't really do a lot of good at that point.
Oh, that thing's more dangerous than a street luge. That thing will do like 150 mile an hour. Street luge
won't. Yeah, but you're not a half inch off the ground.
It doesn't want to roll, right?
The ground is just as hard. I assure you, the 5 feet from your head to the ground on a bike versus the 2 inches from your head to the ground on a luge, that is not the distance that's going to fuck you up. It's everything that happens in the minute after that.
What did you have to luge up to?
The luge, I think our top speed so far is like 32, I think.
But that wasn't anywhere near.
No, it's nowhere near full power. Hell, that was only with two motors.
Right, okay, because one spun out.
Yeah, we blew up a motor. I got to get two replacement motors.
Yeah, because you have to have four.
We're going in a minute.
You bothering those dogs?
No.
Why not? That's what they're for.
I've bothered them.
Come here, I'll teach you who's who. The big one is Elisa's. The black one is Mackie.
Mackie.
And the little one is Menchie.
Menchie.
Yep. Elisa's, Mackie, and Menchie.
Okay.
Hi, dogs.
She likes to nibble her tennis ball at the same time and trying to give it to me.
Yeah. She likes a good tennis ball.
Stacy likes to nibble. Grab it.
It's because it's got really good dirt on it. It tastes the best. Oh, shit, I missed it.
Well, wait a minute now.
You still got the same problem.
Are your latches?
No, we're
going to latch it to it, but are your latches going to hold?
You're still going to have the same problem. Once you
Mr. Minkus? Remember you were asking about the climax? The moment that landed, that was the climax.
Ugh!
I missed it. I was playing with the dogs.
No, see, now that we've got it like this, we're going up one more. We've got the pallet jack.
If we get these all latched up there, going on. Because the frame's pretty lightweight.
I can totally get that off those. That's easy. No, I can do it with the weight and everything on there. Without the forklift.
Chainsaw, just cut the straps?
No.
No, because then they're still on there.
That's still I can get off the cribbing. I got a plan.
Burn the cribbing.
No.
I like the way you think.
Dynamite.
He wore off on me a little bit. I think your step one is usually burn it.
Burn the cribbing, no, kill everyone.
Step one is rip it apart with the truck first. If that doesn't work, then you blow it up. Tannerite.
I got Tannerite in the truck, we're good.
We don't have Tannerite around here, do we?
No, I have way, 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 way better than Tannerite. Tannerite's the stuff you can just, like, order on the internet.
It's still fun, though.
Oh, it's big fun.
We did, for a friend's bachelor party, we did Tannerite snowmen.
Oh, dear God.
So we made, like, the biggest fucking snowman you've ever seen. And we put Tannerite in the center of each half or third of the body. And then we just went to town on it. It was the coolest thing, because the first part we got was the torso. So the head just floated in space for a microsecond, right? Because you're like, go, and there's that split second where all the adrenaline hits you, and you're watching as the head of the snowman falls, and then just splits in two on the lower half.
No, I do electrical Tannerite.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's the high voltage guy.
Yeah, he showed me some videos.
Yeah, that. We have fun here.
Yeah.
You need to get Gemini going.
We're working on it.
I know you are.
We just got a new welding table for making parts.
Yeah, okay. He welds like art.
He's a pipe fitter. That's what they do.
No. He's not a welder for his job. He's a pipe fitter.
That involves the professional, delicate manipulation of metal. And
yeah,
a lot of swearing.
He was a welder at first.
A lot of swearing.
He was a welder at first. That's why.
Yeah? Hey, you got any scratches on your helmet?
Maybe.
Probably.
Okay. It fell off the bike while you were inside.
This is usually where I'm hanging out nowadays because way more to the lift. And a fire truck that needs brakes. It's losing brake fluid, so it doesn't leave a car.
Should I take these in? Or should I leave them out?
Keep those out.
Runs pretty hard, 429 4 barrel.
Really? just dropped
pallet jack a little higher than the bottom line.
This is this is the greatest engineering ever. It's the wrong way. Up's the other way. He's an engineer. He knows how to operate it. He knows stuff.
I'm fully on.
Yeah, I have no doubt.
Right now, lower the coming down.
Yeah.
Down and
see you, Jack.
Come on out. Oh, it's beautiful. It's a nice bike.
Yeah. Actually, let's move back to JD and Bob's car.
Have fun! That's the happiest kid in America.
He's got his own quad, his own little dirt bike. Good kid. They were my neighbors.
Stop! I wouldn't take it all the way down.
Yeah, because you'll drag
those. Not with those casters in the parking lot. Let's get them on the nice floor.
So you got to go up, yeah, because you're two by.
Well, you got to get in there and push.
Well, the cribbing was on the outer wheel.
You're not pushing. You should be pushing. That's beautiful.
That's a welding table right there.
Yep. You got to keep Minkus away from it.
No, I think we will just have
otherwise
to
it'll still, have a mirror still, finish
yeah.
on it.
Yeah, and we'll just rinse it off. Katie, you want to grab the pal jack and then we'll all wrestle it?
You don't have to.
No,
you want me to take that table off there?
We have a hoist?
Yeah, that's what I'd use, the hoist. I was like, you're lined right up for it. I just come in, grab it with a hoist, pick it up 2 inches, and set it back down. Yeah, that's easy. No, you damn fool.
You muppet, put it under the plate.
God.
Well, I'm just going to go off an hour.
You can't adjust it when it's in the air.
Yeah, you can.
Don't.
Bruce,
you pull this right there. Now swing that wherever you want it. See how that shit works? Stop! Now you lift this up, you swing that out. You gotta lift that up with one hand. You swing that with the other.
I missed the coordinating part.
Okay. Oh, right there's good. Right,
well,
right,
it was catching the other rib.
It doesn't matter. You just send it right in. You can pick it up here.
Okay. I didn't want to put the weight on there.
Where are they grabbing it?
I just put it right at the edge of the table.
Oh, all right. Well, if they're doing it like that,
2-inch lip for the win.
Hang on. Yeah, you're good.
Well, not really.
He's good here. He's not good there. Good. It's all fucked up.
You'll be fine.
Get it.
Oh, it's not.
Yeah.
You know whose fault that is?
Rob.
That's that Scion.
Yeah, it's a Scion that did it.
We have to do this on Squeak's car, too.
Yeah?
Yep.
Hit it while he's got fingers in there.
He's got lots of fingers.
I have 10. I certainly don't need all of them.
Grow back, right? If you don't lose,
you're practically a starfish.
All right, but good
enough.
Yeah, everybody clear?
It'll be fine. Stop. Down. Hey, Minkus. Boom, there's another climax for you. Dual climaxes.
Thank you, Bruce.
Now we tighten the plate down to the thing, and it's lovely.
Not that I'm going to make much of a difference.
You made a difference. It's going down about, like,
fraction, marginally faster?
Yes.
So then this should help, too? Some ballast.
Oh, yeah, you're massive weight.
240.
Yeah, but you're 9 feet tall.
Yeah, but not right now. As far as the lift is concerned, it's... The pins come up when it goes down.
Yeah.
Hey, Mitch.
Yeah?
Mazel tov. It's a welding table.
It's a boy. It's brilliant.
Wow. Watch the vibration on those.
Yeah, well, yeah. There's something caught in front of it.
Yeah, you locked it, I think.
You just locked it. Yeah.
There you go, Mitch.
Mitch, you locked the wheel there,
smarter,
Mitch.
Smarter, not harder.
vibrate like this and think that is kind of scary.
It's because the floor's uneven.
It doesn't matter. I wouldn't be on that side of the table when it's moving that way.
Okay.
I'd push from behind but never pull from in front.
That's fair enough.
New and untested design. If that thing folds up, you don't want to be under it.
I agree.
I'll get good video as you move it over there and you'll get to see.
I just thought.
Now if you can keep Minkus away from this, it'll stay looking like a proper welding table.
Yeah, no, I just need it.
You leave him alone with this for like 2 hours, you're going to come back, it'll look like a mirror.
It'll be broken in half.
It'll be
pregnant.
No, it'll be polished.
Or broken in half and pregnant.
No, Minkus... Minkus is, okay, has a thing with metal.
Go look at the bottom of that boat.
I know. Get to work.
Go look at Andrew.
No, he's got actual important shit to do, not polishing something that's going to look like this no matter what in 6 months.
Yeah, but that's 6 months.
Well, you know what?
That's a return on investment.
It's steel. It's not as easy as aluminum.
It's not, it's a lot.
Aluminum's more fun.
This is also, like, air 500, so it just like, doesn't.
Yeah, true.
But yeah, if we hit this with a wire brush, it'll look a lot better.
You should have seen the clouds you just put on Saturday night.
It's pretty fantastic.
That's why I was. No, I was up north doing another shit. Playing with chainsaws and stuff.
Juggling chainsaws?
Yeah, can't you tell one arm? You know, I'm part Italian. If I had one arm shorter than the other, I'd have a speech impediment.
Oh.
Chris, did you not inform...
Does that thing start yet?
Of course it does. Did you not inform back...
I got the starter motor running.
Let's start it. It's not my pressure. When we last left our hero, you were off to get a gas can.
I did, and I hooked it up, and... so I need to charge the battery.
There's a battery right over there you could use.
Yeah, just take the one out of that blue boat. Did you not tell Beck you were going to use one of her precious robot stands for the welding table? Because she seemed to be oblivious to this.
Now you know.
This was owned from the very beginning.
What?
This was owned from the very beginning. Yeah, this came in, we're like, this is our new welding
this
table.
This was extra from the start. We can't use this stand. We don't have a robot that big.
Oh.
This stand only fits the big robot.
Justin.
Yeah, and we can't put this stand on the floor because the pins don't line up. But this is the GM pin system, and we went with the KUKA standard, not the GM standard.
Because ISA.
Yeah.
Not GM.
Yeah. 18, 12 hours. Mr. Minkus is experimenting with nipple clamps. Hang on. I want to get where I can get a good shot of this. This is your moment of glory.
For lack thereof.
Didn't start.
I know it didn't start.
That's a bad sound. Well, it's got good compression. Do you need more battery than you have?
Probably.
Okay.
That's why I was using the bigger interstate. And that's the one that needs to be charged.
Alright. Well, we'll put it on charger. I would recommend, you know, using these, and there's probably a little switch somewhere for a starter relay.
You had to hook...
What?
I didn't see no starter relay nowhere.
It's right there.
Oh, yeah. Well, anyway, where's the switch?
Okay, so I'll go up there and do the switch, and you do the... But, yeah... There's a switch right there. It says ignition.
I'll be in for a little bit tomorrow to do cleaning too.
Okay,
so
cool.
We can try it then.
But the contact surface of the contactor there is a lot bigger than the contact surface of just the thing, right. So you'll get a better current flow. But starter motor works. You took it totally apart. You put it all back together, and the thing works.
You doubted it?
Well, it still doesn't start.
Yeah, but the starter motor runs.
Yeah, let's see. So. It starts to start. That's it. Did the starter motor didn't work at all before?
I don't know.
Oh.
I didn't test it.
You just ripped it apart without...
No, we had to replace the return spring.
Okay. You don't have to take the whole motor apart to do that.
To tighten down
the top. Yeah, take off one nut.
yeah,
to do that.
Yeah, you can take it off, but putting it back on, you can't.
Okay.
The nut on the bottom there to hold the Bendix.
Yeah.
It spins the same direction you got to tighten it, so it won't stay. So you can actually.
So you have to actually take the motor apart to put the nut.
That's
on.
That's what it says in the manual, actually, too.
Wow.
Take it out, put it in a soft draw vise, and.
Huh.
Fairly simple.
Yeah, it's just a pain in the ass for just one nut.
Right.
So far, though, it's cool. That came out nice.
At least that good at finding things.
Now we got to get some bolts this size that aren't robot mounting. We got to get some bolts this size and some nuts for them too, and then we can use these holes and we can
custom
clamping and fixturing mojo.
If you take like a standard F clamp,
okay,
you know, like a bar clamp,
yeah,
you can slide the bent part through the bottom and then just put the top part on the top.
Okay,
and then you don't even have to worry about hole mojo.
It's a damn fine table you got there, Mitch. Came out nice.
You'll make Batman a happy man when he gets back.
Yeah, we're gonna hit it with some wire brush and
okay.
Knock some shit loose. Which we might want to wait until we get the forklift up and running to do that.
Because why?
It's gonna churn up a cloud of dust. That'll ravel the dust bowl.
Oh, okay.
So it'd be nice if we could do it out here, but I don't want to roll it across the threshold.
All right.
Today's Captain's Blog is brought to you by Paul Plusa.